To the Steam release of Metro Exodus. So this is the best Metro game so far, but sadly it didn't improve a lot on the other two games. So even though it might have seemed open world with a lot of options, it's still the same thing, more or less. And the story will be a little more different this time. Now, I wanted to play on Rager Hardcore, but the game has that stupid thing where it makes you play the game like it's a stealth game, but you don't really have a lot of options to play it. So I don't know why they make you play like it's stealth, because it's not. I played 1 hour on Rager Hardcore and I was a bit disappointed, because again, you just have to know where the enemies are and kill them. Other than that, you have no other stealth options, more or less. So if you want to play on Rager Hardcore, know that the game can be finished in about 6 hours if you know how to play it, and not really worth it. You can just do some fast runs on it, but first time play on normal or hardcore. Also, the game is a bit weird that it starts you in a very, very bad mood. Oh, you'll see what I mean. It's kind of grim dark,
still
especially.
Remember life before the war. I remember that we used to be different. Used to live up there, on the surface. We used to be the masters of the whole world. We built gigantic cities of glass and steel. We crossed the oceans at will. And we also conquered the skies. There used to be 7 billion of us. We were not born for life in the tunnels. I was born to breathe fresh air, and I remember it. The 7 billion were wiped out by the last war. Only 50,000 managed to survive underground, with the surface poisoned, burnt, and teeming with horrible monsters. One day, the radiation on the surface might subside, and our grandchildren, or their grandchildren, might be able to return there. At least that's what my brothers in arms from the Order believe. Basically, there was no hope for us right off the start. Still, we humans are just too bad at surrendering. We tried to make the best of what we had, banded together, and worked to make the Metro our new home. After all, it might well be the only place left on Earth for humans to live. For a time, we thought we could make it. But, regrettably, the war didn't kill our bad habits. In the relative safety of the tunnels, corruption festered. And when danger came from above the ground, only a few of us stood against it, our numbers dwindling by the day. But I remember we were born for a better life, and I can't accept that I'm destined to grow old and die underground. I don't care if I'm called an idiot. But if even a single shard of the old world still exists out there, I have to find it. Between endless years of hopeless existence and even a single moment of hope, I must choose hope. I must find that signal.
Well, hope is a very dangerous thing, as many people will tell you. Now, the problem I have with this game is that, well, in the other games you had to fight and kill the Dark Ones, you had to conquer D6 and kill some Nazis, maybe some communists along the way. But here you're just left to the option to leave because, you know, resources are very low. And only, as he said, only the Order, the Spartans, actually protect the metro. The other factions are engaged in pointless wars most of the times. So yeah, either you leave the metro or you die there. And believe me, the game makes it very, very clear you have no hope of staying in the metro because no more resources, no more medical supplies, and a lot of radiation. Also, again, very few people are, I don't know, are determined to protect the metro and the way of life. But again, the story will take another turn very, very soon. So let's enjoy Artyom. By the way, tanks and APCs in the streets. That's a very, very, very bad sign. So yeah, the game kind of starts very, very grim, dark, and it will be a little better later, but it's still the same formula. So yeah, if you want to enjoy this game better, you better read the books, otherwise it will be kind of an unpleasant experience. I love that demons are flying over our head. So yeah, that was kind of like the bad parts of the game, and as I said, the stealth didn't really improve. And the game still feels very, very claustrophobic in some sections, meaning you will not like it if you want, you know, just a RPG experience or a open world experience, that is. By the way, this is a shotgun, even if you can't tell it. And you also have to change a lot of keys, because apparently this game was made for consoles mostly. As you can see, my sensitivity is pretty high right now because I changed it. Now, don't worry about this section because you don't need to start looting and being a loot goblin. We can just admire the scenery. Again, this game has the best scenery in the game, and especially the atmosphere. So that, they never got this wrong. They really make you feel like you're in the metro. Of course, we have the Watchmen, or enemies forever. And that was a huge spider on my arm. Anyway, that's the funny part with the spider. And of course, a lot of human remains everywhere. Again, the main theme of the game is to actually leave the metro because you have no chance of surviving here and find other people. So the game does feel clunky at times because, as I said, it's not really made for a stealth game or for an action game. It's made to be a hybrid, and that's what people won't like about it. Yeah. Let's have some more spiders on our hands. Well, look at that. Now, let's see. You can find some weapon modification strictly in the weapon... I don't know, in the weapons that you can pick up. So that was actually a magazine. Now you can equip more bullets. Okay. Kind of gives you... He has a mushroom growing out of this. Oh, he was a miner or something? Mushroom growing out of his belly. Again, this is the introduction part, so let it all sink in. Don't rush it, don't expect anything to... Yeah, they're above us. Don't expect anything to... You know, this is more like the horror part of the game. And I wish this part of the game would last longer, but no, sooner or later you'll be back to fighting humans and killing humans and, you know, the usual war. Knock knock. I wish that was in English, if someone can tell me what that means. So again, this is just exploring the metro. I I don't really like the spiders in the game. They are too real, and of course they are mutated spiders. Also, this is a big mutant over here. And one thing I don't really like is that there are too many cutscenes or, you know, fight scenes where you have to kill the Watchman in melee combat. Look at him. He was devouring a leg before he was killed. Boom. So you don't have to pick up everything, you don't have to get everything from here. Okay, 11 bullets in the gun right now. I'll actually speed up the game a little when we are out of this section. Yeah, I mean, it's not a bad game, but you have to... Oh well, let's just get on. Hey, I missed my shot. Yeah, let's get out of here because they are so dangerous. Well, you can only look at this part, so yeah, that's a nice chandelier. Looks like Artyom's been on another one of his mad trips up top.
Poor kid. He got hey, too many explosions at D6. Where to now?
Left, across the square. Hey, Demir, do you think the Colonel knows what Artyom been up to here?
How am I supposed to know? Ask him yourself. He radioed from the ring, said he'd be here tomorrow. Hey, you, leave him alone.
I killed him myself with my slingshot.
Let him learn to stand up for himself. Yeah, how right. Else can he hope and to survive in the metro?
Rise and shine, people!
Hang in there, Artyom. You're gonna get a fresh dose of Spartan blood now.
That sounds lovely. Almost like we are a vampire. So yeah, your basic goal in this game is escaping the metro because you have no chance of surviving here for a long time. But that's a little weird how they do it. Because you, of course, start the same way as you start the other games, fighting the Watchmen, and I don't know, I expected more to change in the game.
Are you awake? It's okay. The doctor said you'll be fine. Are you trying to kill me with worry? What if next time you don't return from the surface? There's no one out there, Artyom. No one to find, no one to talk to. If there was, don't you think they'd be here already? We've talked about this again and again. You have to accept it. There's only us.
Colonel! Hello, Alex. There you are, you stubborn fool. How many times are we going to have this conversation? I don't care if you kill yourself over this silly dream of yours, but don't you see what you're doing to my daughter? Your wife?
Dad, please.
The order is short on men after the battle for D6, but you leave. People need you, and you pursue your selfish obsession. But now this shit has to stop. There's only Metro, nothing else. And the Order is here to defend it. Because if not us, then who? You look fine to me. So, get ready to go. Then, we'll discuss your transfer to police. Come, we need to talk.
I'll get the doctor. Artyom? Please, promise me this was the last time. I'll see you later.
It will not be the last time, as you can imagine, and they are very easy to convince, so...
Artyom, we managed to bring you back from the brink, but people are giving you their blood, which could save so many wounded, and you keep bringing it back irradiated. Don't you think that is unfair?
Well, it's only blood.
Let me put it this way. I can't promise I'll be able to bring you back next time.
Yeah, our character seems a little selfish, but you'll be bombarded with exposition why you should leave the Metro very soon.
Well, sadly, it's their job.
Job or no job, if they keep doing that.
Yeah. Hello, little one.
Uncle Artyom, don't worry. I believe you. Will you take me with you when you find the clean place outside?
And how long do you think that's going to last? How many kids are there in the station? In all Metro? Who will be left here in 10 years?
Metro 2034.
Stop putting delusions into his head. I don't want him going crazy like you.
Well, the basic story is that our grandchildren will never see the outside world because they will die in this place.
What will we do if all the Spartans come down with radiation poisoning like
us? Okay, yes, yes, yes. The bombardment with exposition. And more exposition over here too.
Artyom, you're all right. You gave us a scare, brother.
Artyom, how are you, friend? I see
Pardon
you're all
me,
right.
Gentlemen, give
this
way.
Calls for a celebration.
Artyom, a few more scars and you'll be completely irresistible to any woman. Speaking of which,
Alyosha,
how are the nurses in the hospital,
guys,
huh?
You just stop crowding him.
Brother.
Welcome back, Artyom.
Idiot.
Privyet, Artyom.
All right, you're all dismissed. I give you 2 hours, people.
Yeah! Oh, it's official.
Yeah. I knew it.
You guys are like
so I brought something.
And here we go again. Please, let's not repeat the last
Hold
time.
Hold on, Artyom.
Yeah, life seems pretty good in the Metro, but it's really not. So then again, you have to, I don't know, 20 minutes, 1 hour of exposition. Depends how you view it. So I'll be playing for another 10 minutes, so I just get past this part where, you know, exposition.
And? More of nothing? Artyom, the only thing I can hear is that Geiger counter ticking. Yes, and there's also those damn things. cawing all the time. Let's go home, dear, please. Don't you think I'd also love to live on an ocean beach or in a green forest? But what good are these fantasies in a silent world? Silent, Artyom? Because it's dead.
No, it's not dead. Again, the game tries to convince you you should not live, when you basically know you should live. I don't know, maybe it's the fault of the chairs or the...
We took our time. Time to replace our filters. Move it! We don't need any extra radiation, darling.
Yes, darling. Maybe you want children someday. Yeah, the game looks amazing, but again, if you saw all the trailers and all the promotional videos, you basically know what will happen.
Kill me if he finds out I went up with you. Twice if he learns we've been to a Hansa off-limit zone. Have you been to all these ruins? See all the destruction. And Moscow had the best anti-air defenses in the country. If this is how it looks now, imagine
Come on, will the elevator come down and crush me? No, it's stable. And they actually let you...
Had to scare a demon away.
Okay.
It was getting too comfortable here.
Yeah, I like this part of the game, but sadly, this is only a small part of the game where you can actually explore and do some other stuff. Okay, let's just leave this place. I think you can pick up a few filters here and there, but... We're still in handhold mode.
Look, maybe you should come back to the Order. We'll move to Polis. Dad says he'll arrange a flat for us. Because if not us, then who? A flat with a kitchen and a shower. Let's go in turns here. It's not stable enough. At least it held. Well, I'd say we're out of the woods. Whoa! Hear that?
Bad time to swap a filter. Okay. Yes, yes, yes. This is the handhold mode, don't worry. Yes, sooner we...
Now the whole area knows we're here.
Sooner or later we won't be able to live here. I know, you keep saying these things. I mean, they have been saying these things for a long, long time. They are getting smarter and stronger and better adapted to the condition, the Watchmen that is. So sooner or later they'll replace us as the dominant species in the Metro. As you can see, exploration is always rewarded in this game, more or less. But the game is so creepy like that. And I like this part of the game, but sadly we'll have to leave Moscow and its beautiful frozen wasteland soon. Yeah, they did a fantastic job with the first part of the game. But as I said, the rest of the game will not even be close to this. So yeah, get ready for a lot of sections in the dark. Excuse me. Ah, whatever.
Hear that? It's a pack. Just what we need.
And they also fight among themselves. Yeah,
I don't get why this zone is off limits to stalkers. The radiation and beasts are nothing special. Stop. The pack is here. So, do we turn this place into Thermopylae? Or do we let them pass?
Wait it out. No, we let them pass. I like my bullets. All of them.
I'm glad they didn't notice us. That was a large pack.
Oh, yes, it was. Again, you can explore this place a little bit, but there's no point. But I just like to look at all the stuff. Oh, I can't carry any more ammunition? Okay, fine by me. So you're not even introduced to the basic gameplay mechanics in the first part of the game, and it's kind of sad. Okay, let's try to skip this a little more. Yeah, I like this part.
Come up now.
Okay, wife, I'm coming up.
I got you. Did you hear that, Arthur? Something large, warm. At least it was far away.
Now that's what I call a blizzard. Can't see a thing. Or hear. Let's switch the radios.
Very atmospheric game, I don't want to ruin the immersion in some parts of it. Is that a train? Yeah, sadly we can't kill them, so this is very, very suspicious from the beginning, but I don't know, you're just forced to go with it because we have no other option. They just hit you in the head. Just like that. So, as you can see, they know about the existence of the train, but something is very, very wrong.
You should have checked first, assholes. Artyom, thank God. These people, they're Hansa, not the Order. Assholes.
Yeah, they're the assholes.
They did a number on you. Well, Dad will rip them a new one for
what's
that.
What's going on in this Moscow of yours, anyways?
Of yours? You're putting this like you're not from here.
We aren't. Our village is about 200 kilometers from here.
What village? You're not from Moscow?
Just a regular village. We came here to find the boy's father. Left for Moscow about a year ago and never came back. But then we got caught by these here.
You mean there's life outside?
Why wouldn't there be any? Sure, there are lots of bad places and lots of beasts around, but we still get by.
Artyom, you're right. People really do live out there.
What a big surprise, right?
We didn't know. We thought we were the only survivors. God, we'll tell the whole metro about this.
I don't think so.
The heck and the boy out!
Hey, you people drove us halfway to nowhere.
They can handle it.
At least give them their masks back.
Gera, get him. He always gets bitten in the hand. Ouch. Now, normally he should be dead by now. He took a fall and, you know, that's about 100 kilograms of weight that dropped on him. Yeah, he could have lived again. They are trying to shock you, but that's not really shocking that they want to protect the metro from the outside. And that there are other people living outside the metro, of course, and in the whole world, probably. Excuse me, mister, are you okay? Ah, you're not okay, but give me that mask. So this is where they kill all the people they encounter, or all the people that want to come to the metro, which is kind of sad. I mean, I don't really understand it. They need people. But no, let's just kill everyone that tries to come near the metro. And as you can see, it's not just 1 or 2 or 3 or 7 or 10 or... It's probably 100 bodies around here. And they have been doing this for years. Okay, see you next episode. Bye!